everyone. I hope you're doing well. It is Monday, September 13th, 2021, and I am doing a second video. I'm feeling like this might be my last video for a while, simply because of where the Lord has me. I have been feeling the broad spectrum of things that are happening in spirit. I'm feeling the heaviness and the weight of what is coming. As a watchman, I've been very sensitive to just share whatever I feel is left to share right now. And then on the other hand, I'm feeling the joy and the elation of the promise and the inheritance that He has bestowed upon us, because it is all happening simultaneously. So I'm coming on here to encourage you, per usual, because we are in a very pivotal month, and the next, as I said before, the next 4 months are very, very pivotal. So I'm sharing as He flows, and the first thing I'm feeling led to say is, again, whatever He's instructing you personally, do it. You don't have time to waste, like, at all. Hopefully you are in a place where you have been preparing as best as we can in our humanity. Like, we have no clue what is coming. It is beyond us on both ends. It is beyond us. But hopefully you are ready to continue in the unknown territory that we are walking into. If you are someone who's being called to provide, I know I've shared this before, but it's a reminder, and you're free to message me at hisdwellingplaceismyrefuge@gmail.com. If you feel like God is calling you to provide a safe haven for others for when things get worse, or if you are someone that is seeking help, that is the way to get a hold of me. And it is a network for providers, to provide for others. So if He's calling you to get food, get water, candles, whatever He's telling you to do, I am urging you to do it now. Don't put it off. Don't wait. This is really ridiculously important to do right now. It's time to get creative. It's time to think outside the box. We are here to occupy until He returns. We are here to share His grace and His mercy and His love and His peace with everyone. And the reason I'm saying to get creative is because it's gonna get harder to do everything within the context of what is considered normalcy now. I know the Lord is translating that for you, so there's a very fine line between it's a very fine line to walk, because we are to be people who represent the Lord, we are to be demonstrating a character that is respectful, and that is obedient to what order that God has set in place, because God has set in place order. But the fine line is when that order counters what God has told us to do. So I'm praying fervently that as you take your next steps moving forward the rest of this year, that He guides you personally on your journey in navigating that in a Christ-like way. And so getting creative means that in order for us to continue what we need to do while we're here, we might need to think outside the box. In fact, we will need to think outside the box. So these are times we've never been in, and they will continue to be as such. So just be true to the calling and assignment He's given you. If you're still at a place where you're not sure, seek Him. He will guide you. He is faithful and merciful, and He will confirm whatever He's spoken to you. So, what else, Lord? When you're confused, go to the Word of God. The truth is in there. Okay. Persecution is coming like never before for the people of God. It's already here, but we need to prepare for more. And the way to be grounded is to remember you are going to be persecuted for what you believe. So you need to brace yourself for it, and you need to arm yourself in the armor of God so that you can stand firm. And continue to walk in love in the middle of the persecution. I know that sounds counterintuitive, maybe, but it isn't. It is who we are. I continue to say this, but guard your eyes and guard your ears from deception. Again, anything that comes at you that feels confusing or unsettling is for a reason. So you need to take it to the Lord in prayer to ask for guidance and wisdom and understanding. So, your friends and family, love them, support them, help them, and understand that they're on their own journey too. And if you're continuing to come up against conflict, take it to the Lord for understanding how to navigate it. Remember, this is the year of divine alignment, so everyone and everything is being divinely aligned. And again, we are to pray and intercede on the behalf of others who can't fully see or hear the truth right now, because they are also being prepared for their time. I know I've shared this. I have videos on preparation for this time that we're in. This is just a reminder to don't take it personal when you cannot agree with the people that you love and the people that love you. And again, you have to navigate that individually, because the last thing you want to do is get caught up in the spirit of division that is happening and lose your footing and lose sight of the love God is calling you to have for everyone, and walking in the truth that He has specifically given you to walk out and to share at this time. So, what else? He's going to call you to do remnant. He's going to call you to do things that are beyond your capability. And that's the point. Because He's going to get all the glory for it. I'll share a quick testimony to give you a little bit of understanding. One of the first Rhema words, and it was actually a personal word that He gave me, was in 2011, which was a very challenging year for me. I was very sick, and I didn't know how I was going to get through. But I heard Him very clearly in my spirit tell me that I was going to prophesy through dance. And at the time, I had actually already prayed for the Lord to remove that desire to dance, because it was too painful for me to have it. So when I got that word, I didn't know what to do with it. And it certainly didn't make any sense. And it certainly wasn't physically possible for me at the time He gave it to me. 2 years later, I was asked by the church choir that I was a part of. Actually, my children were a part of. This was a large church. There were many kids there, I mean, hundreds of kids. And my kids were in the choir, and they called me and asked me if I wanted to choreograph for them. And of course I said yes, but I was not confident to do it. I did not physically feel qualified. I had been trying to get back into shape, but I did not feel ready. Every time I went to class, the Holy Spirit took over and gave me every ounce of energy and creativity that I needed to teach those children. And it was the first experience that I had of literally feeling the Holy Spirit take over and move through me. He's going to do that with all of us. If you feel like what He's calling you to do is bigger than yourself, that's the point. It is bigger than you. Everything He's calling us to do is beyond our capacity. because we have entered a time of kingdom on earth as it is in heaven, purpose. So I had to get to a place where I gave him the gift that he gave me. I said, I didn't think I could handle it, so I gave it back to him, and he anointed it and gave it back to me. So if you're in a place where you're trying to figure all that out, I encourage you to give him the gift that he's given to you so that he can anoint it and bless it so that you can carry it and carry it well moving forward. He's going to provide. Don't worry. He is our provider.